गुड आफ्टरनून
Afternoon, children. Good afternoon, everyone. It gives me immense pleasure in welcoming the speaker of the day, Mrs. Harshita Chowdhury. She has completed MBA in HR from TISS, one of the most prestigious institutes for human resource, that is HR, and has been an HR professional for the last 13 years. She is working as organization development and talent manager in Freshworks Technologies. She has a wide range of experience working with big companies like Nestle, Cadbury, Colgate-Palmolive. She also is among the top three most inspiring women manager by Incedium 2021. We are indeed elated to welcome you, madam.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I'm very, very happy to be here and looking forward to the session.
It's my privilege to welcome our secretary, sir, madam correspondent, principal madam, vice principal madam, staff and students of Mahatma Gandhi Centenary Vidyalaya. Over to you, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am. And super excited to be talking to all of you. I've been doing some of these talks and been doing that with Aditya. I'm always very excited because while I get to share what I have done and, you know, just tips from my journey so far, and just so far, I still have a long way to go. It's always very exciting to also hear from you, hear your questions, hear your comments, hear your inputs. And it's always very value adding even for us as we move forward as professionals. So I really invite all of you that at any point in time during the session or at any or towards the end, I'd love for all of you to ask me questions, give me comments on how or on some of the things that I'm saying. What I'm going to do is I'm an HR professional and I work with people, right? That's the job I've been doing for the last 13 years. And from my experience, I will share you how my journey has been. I wouldn't talk about my roles and my companies, but I'll really talk about how did I reach over there, some of the learnings that I have had, and also would like to understand of...
Students, please mute your microphones, if you don't mind, please.
Okay, thank you so much for that. So, and at any point in time, you have any question, ask me. I'll tell you about my learning, some experiences, some of the things that I feel have led me to where I am, to the little success that I've achieved in my life. And let's take it forward from there. So I have a deck. I'm just going to share. I'm just going to request Aditya. Let me know if you can see my deck, Aditya. Yeah? Students, one or two of you are still not on me. It will really help for us, all of you, to be on me.
Badri Vishal.
Badri, you're not on mute. Can you go on mute, please?
Badri Vishal. Aditya, can you mute him?
Okay. Okay. I think we have silence from there. He's still not mute. I think he's muted. Yeah, great. So what I'm going to do is just share, as the slide says, learnings from my journey so far. Aditya, you can see my slides, right? And you can hear me, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So I'm just going to share some learnings from my journey so far. And I again call it so far. I typically feel that we have a career of 40 to 45, 50 years in our life. And career, when we work in companies and career, we have...
just 1 second. Sure. I'll mute everyone. And
maybe you can mute the
person. Yeah. Sorry about that.
No, no problem at all. Fine. Okay, I'm good at that. I think you can hear. Yeah. Anybody has any questions, you can even type on chat. We're just muting everybody so that there is not too much noise behind you. Yeah. So I'm just going to share some parts of my journey. Before I go there, I want all of us to think of one question that I have for all of us. And Aditya, you may want to unmute them after this. Is that who is your role model? And why is that person your role model? For example, I'll tell you, one of my role models is one of my managers that I have worked with. And why she's my role model is because I feel that the way she talks, the way she communicates, it's very, very clear. And she really talks in a way which motivates the other person. So that's why she's my role model, right? Can I have any of you talk about who are your role models and why do you think they are your role models? Can we do this small activity? Can I have one person from every class talk to me? Is my slide not moving? Yeah. Can I have someone talk? Ma'am, can you call out a couple of students who could answer for me? All of you have role models? Show of hands. There are our students. Yeah, very good. So Rahul, tell me, you have a role model, right? Rahul KS. Who's your role model? And what is that one quality in the person that you really like? Rahul? Yes, Suganya, you can tell. Please go ahead. Suganya just chatted with us. Go ahead. You'll have to Aditya, you may have to unmute them. Suganya, Aditya, have you unmuted them? Yeah. Suganya, can you try unmuting, please? Not happening. Aditya? Okay, Suganya, can you chat? Can you type on chat? Can you do that? Okay, Aditya? Okay, Suganya, I think I'm not able to get a hang of Aditya. Would you like to just type on chat, please? Aditya, are you there? Ma'am, can you hear me? Hello? Ma'am, can you hear me? Okay. So Suganya, your role model is Rohini ma'am, right? Thumbs up? Can you do a thumbs up to tell me it's, I'm reading it correctly? Correct? And... Okay. Suganya's role model is Rohini ma'am. And Suganya, why is Rohini ma'am your role model?
I'll just unmute it.
Yes. Thank you, Aditya. Yeah,
Suganya, so you can unmute, ma'am.
Unmute. Yes, please go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. My ambition was IAS and my role model was Rohini IAS, ma'am.
Okay, and what is that one thing about Rohini IAS that you really like?
Suganya, once again, just unmute yourself, ma'am. I've changed the setting now so that people can unmute themselves if needed. Okay, can you just unmute yourself? Sir. Thank you.
I like she was helping the farmers. Ma'am?
So the quality you like about her is the fact that she was helping the farmers, uh-huh. Right? So yes, in addition to being their IAS, she was also helping the people, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Awesome. Thank you for the answer. Who else will go next? Okay.
Ma'am, can I?
Yes. Who's that?
Alicia.
Yes, please go ahead, Alicia.
My role model is my mom.
Okay. And why is that, Alicia?
She is my first teacher and my advisor and my support system.
Okay, so she's in addition to being a great parent, she advises you very well, right? Is she generally good with people and she advises people?
Yeah.
Okay, very nice. Thank you for sharing. Radesh, you've told that your role model is your father. Radesh, can you unmute and tell us why, what is one quality about your dad that you really, he works very hard. So in addition to being your dad and being good at his job, he works very hard, right? Okay. Okay. So working very hard, helping people, being a good advisor, some of the qualities that you're saying. Srinidhi, would you want to go ahead? Srinidhi, are you there? Srinidhi, would you want to unmute? Okay, Radha, please go ahead.
I actually have multiple role models in my life.
Tell me one best.
My favorite one is probably my grandfather.
Okay, and why is that, Radha? Apart from being your grandfather,
he's a very determined person, ma'am, and he knows what he wants and he gets it. And I like how he is very focused on what he does. I'm not like that. I'm trying to be like him. He has had a very huge impact on my life.
Very nice. So the quality that you like in your grandfather, other than, of course, the affection as a grandfather, is that he's very focused, right? He works very hard to and determined. So focused and determined to achieve what he wants, right?
Yes.
Very good. And I'm sure you'll pick up that quality. Don't worry. You have a long, long life ahead. Don't worry about that.
Thank you, ma'am.
Mahati, you've sent me a direct chat and I'm just going to read for you. So Mahati's role model is her teacher. And her teacher is because is having a lot of knowledge, and that is why Mahati says that the teacher is the role model. Knowledge is the first base of us looking up to someone. When someone has knowledge, someone has education, we like that kind of space, we look up to them. So knowledge is another good quality for being a role model, right? Okay. Great. Nice. I'm just going to read everybody's messages. Okay, just one second. Radhesh, we read. Anybody else? Yes, Lasya. I was just going to take your name. Yes.
Yes. There are so many role models for me, but my favorite one has to be Emma Watson, and from the Harry Potter movies.
Okay. And why is that? Why is Emma your role model?
Ma'am, she has stood up for many female activities, and she has worked with UNICEF to provide education all over the world, ma'am.
Okay.
She is still striving to provide education to the girls around the world who has not received education, who have been exploited.
Very nice. So Emma, apart from being a good actor, has also shown how she can help people work in the space of education, and that's why she's your role model, right? I believe Aditya was talking to you just before when my session started that there is not only one role that we play in our life, there are many roles that we can play in our life, in our education. Remember, the biggest strength that God has given us, and I always feel, is that God has given us the ability to be educated. God has given us the strength and parents and everything in our life to get education. And I think that's our biggest strength. And as people, as you grow up in your careers, and when you become as old as I am, or Aditya is, or your teachers are, remember to pay it back to the society. Use your education to show the way to others, right? I always feel that is our biggest strength. You know, we bring knowledge, we bring education, and we should always share it. When you share education, when you share knowledge, you will learn more. Right? That is why I always get any opportunity to do sessions like this. I always do, because I feel I learn a lot, right? So always remember, education is one of our biggest strengths, and we should be always thankful for it in our life. Yeah. A lot of people don't get the opportunity, right? And also to make the best use of it when you have it. Anybody else would like to share? Alvi, your hand's up, but would you like to unmute and share? Alvi, you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Alvi. Who's your role model and why?
My ambition is doctor.
Okay, you want to be a doctor? Okay. So who's your role model, Alvi? Okay, I think we have a little
role model is my father.
Your father. And why
role
is that?
Role model is my father.
Okay. And why is your father your role model?
Because my father was doctor and helping others.
Okay. Very nice. So apart from just being a good dad and doing what he does, he also helps others. That's a very, very important thing. Okay. So we have Janani, and I'm going to take that as the last one and move forward. Janani's role model is Akila Jilan. She's her mom's friend. She's a role model because she's very energetic, very humble. She motivates a lot of people. She not only motivates me, but also has been working around the pandemic. And she is Akila's role. She is Janani's role model. Okay. Radha, I think we spoke to Radha about Emma. And Okay. Yeah. Okay. So remember, when we talk about role models, and thank you so much for all of you for sharing your inputs and your comments on that. Why do we have a role model? We have a role model because that person motivates us or inspires us and helps us to do more. And we can look forward to become like that person, right? You don't have to be that person, but that person inspires and motivates you. And in all the responses that we got in the class, if you saw, everybody spoke about Emma is a good actor, but in addition also helps people. My granddad is a good granddad, but is also nice because it's very focused and determined. So remember, apart from the experience or the person that they are, whether they're an actor, they're a doctor, they are a psychiatrist, et cetera, there is an additional quality they have. There is something additional to their education, to their experience. Like I'm an HR person and I work in HR, I've worked for 13 years, but somebody may consider me as a role model because maybe my communication is great, or maybe the way I give people guidance is great, right? So that's what motivates people, right? It's not just what you study, what is the education, but it is also what you do with it, right? So remember, role models are people who inspire us because they do something with what they have, right? They have education, they will inspire. They are a doctor, they will do something to help people. So that is what role models are. And one should, I would recommend, have a role model because you should have an inspiration in your life, right? So that brings me to another point. So what is it? What are the two most important things for success? Any success, whether it is your role model success, whether it's a little success that I have, or anybody's success, there are two very, very important things. And I want to start the session with this and then take you through how I have built these two things in my life, right? One of the most important things is your aptitude, right? So you have to be good at your subject, whether it's your education, whether it's your courses, whether your experience. So what is aptitude? For me, HR is my study. Yeah, human resources is my study. I have done additional courses to become a coach, to become a mentor, to become an assessor, et cetera, et cetera. And there are my experiences. So I've worked in a Nestle, I've worked in Colgate, I've worked in the manufacturing sector, I have worked in the IT sector, technology sector, and today I work in a SaaS company. What is SaaS? SaaS is software as a service, right? So those are my experience. That is my aptitude, right? But with aptitude to be successful, what is very, very important? Your attitude, right? Attitude is what a lot of us spoke about when I asked you, what is that one thing that you think is different about your role model? Somebody spoke about being focused. Somebody spoke about helping people. Somebody spoke about being hardworking. Somebody spoke about guiding, right? All of that is aptitude. What do you do with all the education, all the experiences you have? How do you show it in your attitude? Attitude is nothing but everything. It's nothing and also everything. That means, how do I talk to people, right? Do they like talking to me? Do I understand people, right? Can I guide people, right? Can I share my knowledge with people? That is your attitude. Can I achieve? Can I work hard? Am I focused? Am I driven? All of that is your attitude. How are you in a team? Today, remember, all of us, any point in time, either at your school or in your college or at my work today, we all work with people. We alone cannot achieve anything. Look at your own self. Even if you're studying a subject, there are your classmates who can help you. There are your friends you discuss with. There are your teachers who are helping you learn something. So we are not alone achieving things. We are always achieving things with people. So it is very, very important to develop as a person who can work very well with people, who's a great team member, right? That should be a huge focus and something you all should think about as you move forward in your education and career. Do you give your best? At every point in time in your life, there will be an opportunity to work hard and achieve more, right? Your attitude should be, in a current situation, wherever I am, whether I'm at school, whether I'm at college, or whether I'm work, am I giving my best? Am I doing my best? Because best will also mean that you achieve more, right? So always remember that for success, any kind of success, whether you give your exams, whether you're going to do a project, whether you're going to do a group study, etc., your aptitude of your knowledge and your attitude of how you show that knowledge will also be important. Make sense? Flash of hands. Are you able to understand? Any questions? Students, you can just flash your hand to say that you're able to understand what I'm saying. Make sense? Awesome. Awesome. Any questions? Or should I keep moving?
No, ma'am.
You can.
Okay. Awesome. Now I'm going to talk to you about my journey. So mine is like a little bit of a mixed journey, right? So I'm not like someone who did science and then who did engineering and then went ahead and did a master's in manufacturing or no. I've been a little bit of a mixed journey, but I will tell you how different parts of my journey came together, right? So like some of you who will be in class 10th or 12th, I was a science student. Right. So I took up maths and bio both in my 10th, right? Rather 11th and 12th, right? I was a decent student. I was always among the first five in class. And so I took up science because I always feel that learning science helped you sort of build a more analytical mind, right? And also, like a lot of us, our parents want us to do science. My parents also wanted me to do science, right? So I went ahead and took science in 11th and 12th. I thoroughly enjoyed it because science really built that problem-solving attitude in you, right? Science looks at everything like a problem. And how do you find a solution? How do you 2 + 2, right? How do you find solutions to a problem, right? So that's what I did in 11th and 12th. I actually did science. But I was always very, very interested. So like Aditya was saying, the other part of me always very interested in reading about history. I always liked, seeing historical movies, right? I was always interested in learning more about our history, foreign history, all of that, right? So I told myself that, and it was a tough conversation with my parents. I'm going to be very honest. Both my parents are doctors and my brother's an engineer. Right. So I come from a very, very science loaded family. Right. And but I said that, no, I want to give it a try. Right. I want to study history. Right. And as luck may have it, I scored very, very good marks in my 12th. And I was able to get, admission into the top history college in the country. And one of those colleges, happy to share the name later, is Lady Sri Ram College. And that's in Delhi University, right? So Delhi University is supposed to be one of the most leading universities, and LSR, as we call it, is supposed to be the leading college in humanities, right? And I said, no, I want to do it. And I want to study history because it really interests me. Before I make the final call on what I will be as a professional, I want to study history. So I went to LSR and I studied. And imagine a science student going and studying history, right? But as luck may have it, I stood first across all my 3 years in college, right? I thoroughly enjoyed studying it. I always felt I made the right choice. And I still wanted to continue doing it. So I went ahead and did an MA in history, right? I'm actually a double master's in my education because I wanted to still try history. You know, I'll always encourage you, whether you take it up as a formal education or something, always try things. If you like things, always give it a try. Whether it's an education or it's a course, always keep trying new things, right? So I went ahead and did a master's in history. And when I was doing a master's in history, you know, I was studying about people in the past, right? People who'd been there, they had fought wars or they had done politics with each other or they had team. I studied about the past of people, right? That's where I realized that if I want to think about my profession, you know, how is it that I'm going to use all the knowledge that I have gained in my education? Remember, through our courses in school, in colleges, etc., we are gathering education, right? What we should think of is what is the best place to use that education? That is profession, right? So what you gain in knowledge in school and colleges as your education based on your interest, that's your education. But you have to use that education to go into the right profession, right? Because profession is where you make a career and then you move ahead and build a life for yourself, right? It's very important to do that well, right? So when I knew that I had an analytical mind and mind who could solve problems through science, I had a mind who understood people through history. For me, I thought the best way to put it forward would be to do an MBA in human resources, right? Because human resources is all about people, How do you work with people? How do you develop people? How do you recruit people, right? So for me, I had to really think, sit down, think, talk to my parents and say that I have these skills, I have this education, and the best profession to for me to be would be human resources, because I can use everything that I have. So students, one of my requests to all of you would be, right, that as you think of what you want to do, one, try what you like, right? You never know what interests it may have and how you can develop your career. When we started our career 13 years back, there were still limited choices, but today you have lots of choices. You have lots of career streams that you can pick up. But remember, always make a career choice where you can use your education. You have knowledge and education. What is the profession you should pick up? You should consciously pick it up, okay? Of course, your parents, what they say in terms of what you should pick up is very important. Your interests should also come in, and then you should pick up something because you will work in that profession for the next 40 years of your life, right? So make that decision very, very well, right? The second thing I would say, and this has been a blessing in my life, I did science from, of course, school. I did history from the best college in the country, right? I did an MA in history from the best university in the country, right? And I did human resources from best college in HR, right? So why I'm saying this is because do it from the best, okay? There should be no compromise on where you study from, right? Give it your best, study in the best, right? And best according to me are these, right? In your times, they may have changed, but study in the best, right? Because what it gives you the best education and it gives you the best exposure professionally. You know, they're going to be the best organizations who will come in a best college in human resources to pick you up as a candidate for their jobs, right? So your opportunity to do will also open up. So remember, while you study, give your competitive exams, work very, very hard to get into the best college, right? And India is blessed to have the best education in the world, right? You don't need to go anywhere to get education. This is the best place to get all kinds of education. So my request would be three things. Explore what you like to, find out where is your interest. Once you have gained good education in that, like I did in science and history, I made a conscious choice of going to HR because it fitted very well with the education I had. And I knew I could use it, right? And third, study in the best. Try for the best. You should always try for the best. Yeah, okay? So that's something on my mixed journey here, right? Any questions? Can I keep moving? Are you able to understand? I need a flash of hands to just know that you're able to understand, right? Just like a hands up, awesome. Thank you, Sadhana. Okay, so I will move ahead. Thank you, Srinidhi. Thank you. Kankatara. If I'm not pronouncing your name correctly, then I'm sorry for that. Okay. Okay. Thank you, Tanya. And of course, I want to share that through this mixed experience that I have, thank you, Varshini, through this mixed experience that I have, what are some of the things that have really been useful? You know, what are some of my learnings? One, try new things. As I said on the earlier slide, always try new things. You may have an interest which may blow up to become a full profession. And there are so many professions that are available in your day and age, which were not there for us when we started. As I say, I am exactly saying what is written on my slide. There is no elevator to success. You have to take the stairs. That means there is no shortcut to success. You have to give a best competitive exam. You have to get into the best college and you have to study the hardest to be in the top five in that college. In anything you do, be the best, right? So there's no elevator or lift to success. You have to take the steps and go. It's difficult. You will get tired by the end of it, but that journey is going to be worthwhile to you. Okay? That's my second one, I will say. I worked hard in every competitive exam, right? Even after our class 12th, we had to write an exam to get into the college. I did that. That was even for a bachelor's college. In JNU, there were only 20 people who are taken for the particular course that I had. You have to work hard and get to the best. This, we used to have a class of only 40 kids among the country, right? And we had to write an exam for it. So give your best, you know, and be in that space for yourself. As I said, whatever you are, be a good one. Whatever you do, you should be the best at it and you should be the best in it, right? So even if you're in TIS, be among the top five or be the top one in the college, right? Be the best at what you do, because that's the enjoyment of it. When you work hard, when you're in something that you like doing, then be the best in it, right? Keep learning, okay? This is one thing I will always say. So like Aditya mentioned, that it's not just about what you study in your class. You know, you should always keep thinking of what more can I learn? From whom can I learn? Who are the people who are in that space that I would be one day like to be as a professional? So keep learning, keep finding out what more you can learn. Keep adding to your skills. I'll give you an example. I have spent 13 years in HR. I have done a number of roles in HR, practically everything that you can do in HR by now I have done, right? But I still every year add something to my education, right? Recently, last quarter, I finished two of my certifications, right? I'm certified from the best college in the country as an HR professional, but still every quarter I try learning something new, right? So it's very, very important that you keep learning and put that habit from now itself. Right? It can be in education, it can be extracurriculars, it can be about a new thing. Develop that ability to learn, right? And the last one is, as you say, it's a bag. Learn from everything. You know, you read a newspaper article, you should find out what you've learned. It may nothing be, but have you learned five good words that day, right? You may be watching a news or anything on TV, what is it that you're learning? You may be interacting with your teacher. See how they communicate to you, how they make you try and understand what is it that you can learn from their communication, right? Sessions like this, I think it's fantastic for your school to have sessions like this. Learn from people like us if you like doing, if you see what we do, you like it. Or learn from anybody in the space that you would want to be. If you want to be an engineer tomorrow, are you reaching out to someone who's an engineer and learning from them, right? So learn from everywhere, right? Keep looking at how you can learn from. You can learn from every part of your life. Like somebody said that, you know, their dad, their granddad, their aunt is their inspiration. There is capacity to learn from every part of your life. And keep looking for that learning. What is the article you're reading, you're learning from? Are you, what is your role model teaching you? What can you learn from your teacher other than just the subject? When you see two elderly people interacting, what can you learn? So learn from everywhere, right? That's the other thing I'll say. There is an opportunity to learn something, okay? That's what I wanted to say here. And the last thing I will say is that in my life, I've done a number of roles. So I recruit people in a company. I make people learn in a company. I make people do well in a company. I find out how they are feeling. I do all kinds of jobs in HR, right? One of the things that has always helped me, you know, whether you're an HR person, whether you're an engineer, whether you're a teacher, whether you're a IS, whether you are anything, whether you're a doctor, right? There is something other than what I said, your education, which is your aptitude, but your attitude, which is very important. And what are those things that help in having a great attitude? Okay, I just picked up this slide because I really liked it. And this is what's really helped me. So how do you develop a great attitude? Okay, question, anybody can answer. Where do you develop a great aptitude from? How can you have a good aptitude? Where do you get a great aptitude from? Somebody was saying something. So we said aptitude is course, education, et cetera, et cetera. So where do you get a great aptitude from?
From school.
Sorry,
from
ma'am?
School around you?
From school, ma'am.
Yes, from school. Lasya, what were you saying?
That was my answer, ma'am. Schools and colleges.
Exactly. The schools, the colleges, the courses, the structured education, all of that is your aptitude. The experiences, like I said, when you start working in every company, you have experience, right? But there is also attitude, right? How do you display that learning? How do you show what aptitude you have? How do you work with people? And that is what we call, in especially the HR language, as soft skills, right? So there are technical skills of your experience, of your education, like engineering, HR, being a doctor. All of these are called technical skills, right? But what displays those technical skills, your aptitude, you know, the way you show them is by using soft skills. So one of the things students I like to really, really stress on is that as you develop your technical education, right, also focus on your soft skills, because soft skills are the ones which actually make you successful, right? Because they add to the plus plus of your education, right? Because remember, you always work with people, and these soft skills will be very important as you especially go ahead and build and go in higher roles in your career. So what are some of those soft skills? And I'll just go through the slide and explain each one of them to you. Communication, right? So Aditya can call me in this session, but if Harshita is not able to communicate and tell people very clearly what is her experience, what has she done, interact with all of you, then there is no point calling me for the session. I can have the best education, but if I can't communicate clearly and inspire you to do something or understand what you're saying, then there is no point. So communication is the base of being successful. You should be great at communicating. Clearly using the words, using simple words, understanding what the other person is saying, all of that comes in communication, right? So focus on communication, learn communication. See people who you think communicate very well and have a very good impact on you. What can you learn from them, right? Communication really makes or breaks a career, right? So it is as important to be successful. Second is self-motivation. All of us will have to, as we grow up, develop self-motivation. You don't always need someone to come and encourage you. You should be able to encourage yourself. You should be able to inspire yourself. That's self-motivation. Third is leadership. You will develop it more as you go forward. But leadership really means is being the best at what you do, right? Inspiring people to do better. That is leadership. Being the first one, leading people, inspiring them, right? This you will develop a little later, but I just wanted to bring out here. Responsibility, right? Lasya spoke about Emma, who feels that she's capable of being responsible to society, and she has that capability. She's being responsible about it, right? So be responsible for your education. Be responsible for your life. Be responsible for everything related to your life, and be responsible for your society, right? Responsibility is another one thing which will make you very successful. Imagine if you're responsible for every work you do. Anybody in a company, anybody in a college would like to work with you because they'll feel the person is responsible, right? The person takes what we call ownership. That means the person says, I will get the work done, right? That's being responsible, right? The next one is, of course, being a team worker, right? Like I said, nothing in life will you achieve alone, right? Imagine now you're teacher is your team, your classmates are your team, your mom and dad are your team. They're all helping you achieve, right? So be a great team worker. Work with people. Develop this in yourself. Read more about it. It's very simple, right? You experiment with it. Work well with people. Be a great team worker. Problem solving, right? Now, this is something, to be honest, naturally in your school you would have developed. Like when you look at a problem, you try solving it, problem solving. But why is it important? It is important because life will always throw up one or the other things at us. Are we positive to look at solutions, right? Are we positive to say 2 + 2 = 4? Can you connect things to solve a problem? Can you be positive to look for solutions, right? That's problem solving. And imagine for me, if I have someone in my team or my colleague or my boss who's always finding solutions, right? Who's very positive, right? It'll be a great person to have, right? So again, problem solving is one thing that you should focus on as a soft skill. How can you find solutions? How can you be positive? How can you connect things to find a problem, to find a solution. Decisiveness, always take decisions. Be responsible, take decisions, right? So if you're telling your parents, I will get into engineering, then take that decision, but own the responsibility of that decision. Okay, so that's the other one. And decisiveness is again something you will see as you grow, right? Ability to work under pressure and time management. So ability to work under pressure will come to you when you go to work, and there'll be lots of things to do that you'll have to manage, but time management, okay? I'm not saying don't have fun. Please have fun, right? Any point in time in any in our life, we should have fun. You know, whether it's your age, my kid's age, my parents' age, we should always have time for everything. So time management is how do you have time for everything, right? But there's a time for everything, right? There's a time to have fun. There's a time to study. There's a time to focus on your soft skills. There's a time to plan for your career, right? So do everything, but manage time. If you are disciplined to learn about and focus on time management from now, it's going to be very useful when you come at my age, right? When you have so many things in life to handle. So I have two kids to handle, right? I have work to handle. I have US-based offices to handle, right? But if you're disciplined, right, you will from now itself learn. And by the time you come to us, you will be superstars, right? You will not be like us all over the place, right? So remember to learn to manage time. Again, remember, time management is about having time for everything, okay? Not just saying, okay, I'll only study. Please have fun, have a hobby, do something with your friends, right? Very, very important, but have time for everything, okay? Flexibility, very, very important. Sometimes the way we want things to happen, things may not happen, right? Do you have the capability of changing your view on that or accepting a different view? Remember, as people who are right now growing in your career, develop this ability to look at different points of views, right? There's not only one point of view which is right, right? Right now, if your parents say something to you, you may react and say, no, I don't want to do it like this. I don't like it, right? That's right, right? Because you're growing up and gathering experiences. Have the ability to understand what the other person is saying. Understand their point of view. That's flexibility, right? And that's really going to help you. Because when you come to an organization to work or a company to work, there'll be so many different people with so many different opinions. Can you hear all of them, right? And can you use all of them to solve a problem? Understand? That's being a leader. Yeah. So that's the other one. Flexibility, very, very important. Okay. And the last one is negotiate and conflict resolution. If you remember, we spoke about problem solving, right? It's very important to solve problems, find solutions. But in all of that, right, can you solve conflicts, right? Do you have conflicts with your parents or with your even teachers sometimes or within your students, right? You have conflicts. So it's good. It's natural to have conflicts, but are you someone who solves the conflicts, right? Who finds out what is the best solution, right? That's about solving a conflict, right? So my request would be, there's a lot of things on my slide. What I'm not saying tomorrow you step out and become the best at all of this, but these are things you should remember. As you gain your technical education, you should always keep building all these soft skills, because the difference between two engineers who are from the same college will be that one speaks better and is able to display their thoughts and is a better problem solving person, though they may be from the same college. That's how your soft skills make a difference. That's how they differentiate you from the other person and make you better, right? Any questions? Are you able to understand? Flash of hands helps me to know that you've understood, or any questions, etc. Okay. Okay. Great. Great. Okay. So this is what really I had to share. I'd love if you all have any questions, any comments, anything. We have, I think, another 10 minutes, and I had prepared to do it for about 50 minutes. Any questions, any comments? Did you find it useful? Would you want to know anything about my journey? Happy to share.
Come on, students. I think we'll open this session for some questions from you guys. So first of all, thank you, Harshita, for that insightful session. I mean, one thing that I can definitely add to it is, in spite of n number of years of experience now, I had so many takeaways from this session as well.
That's so very kind of you.
Thank you, Harshita. So students, what are the questions you have? I'd be happy if you come forward and ask them. Feel free to ask any doubts about Harshita ma'am's career journey, how she has gone about, you know, structuring her choices, what were some of the academic choices she had to make along the way. I'm sure she's already elaborated them. But if you have any further specific questions about that, this is the time to ask.
I have an MBA in HR. Any questions on why should you do it, not have it, anything? Any questions? You can chat or you can unmute and talk. I'd love if some of you will unmute and talk.
Come on, guys. Come forward.
Okay.
All of you ask a lot of questions. Any direct questions, Harshita? I don't see anything yet.
Mahati is saying, ma'am, it is our aim. Mahati, can you unmute and tell me what you're saying? I'd love to understand that. Achha, what is my aim? Are you asking me that? Mahati, are you asking me what is my aim? Can you say a yes?
Maybe you can come forward and answer, ma'am. Ask questions, ma'am.
Okay, Mahati is asking me what is my aim. Okay. My aim is, of course, to do very, very well in my career, be the HR head for a company, right? That's my aim. I want to do very well in my profession, and my profession is in HR, human resources. So one day I want to become the HR head of a company, and I'm preparing my experiences in that line so that I have all the experiences for it. But my second most important thing is that I just want to be someone that... That when people interact with me, you know, they should feel happy about it. They should feel that I added to their journey. I added to their growth, right? My aim is that. My aim is to become that.
Okay, guys, there seems to be some technical issue on Harshita's side. Okay, so students in the meanwhile, any questions that you have for Harshita ma'am, please come forward and ask. Just rejoin. But any questions you have for Harshita ma'am, in the meanwhile, you can come forward and ask. Any questions, guys? Keerthi, do you have a question?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please come forward. Yeah, what is it?
I need to know how do you overcome distractions while attaining a goal? I mean, okay. Whether it may be a small or a large goal,
Aditya, I'm sorry, my laptop's giving some issue.
No issues at all, Harshita. I think you got the question, right?
Yes, I have. So how do you manage distractions, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I think one of the ways to manage distractions is to stay very focused on your aim, right? If you're very clear of what you want to achieve, if you know how you'll achieve that, and if you're very motivated for it, right, then you will manage any distraction in your life, right? And it is not easy, but be very focused on your aim. If you're inspired, and one of the things I would really suggest is think that you are already successful. Think what you will feel, you know, when you will achieve that success. When you will be able to imagine that, it will motivate you more and more to move towards it without any distraction. Always imagine in your head while you are on that journey that you are successful. Let yourself feel that, because it will push you more and more to achieve what you want to achieve, right? And always break your journey, right? You want to get somewhere. What is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 you will do for it? Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Okay. Awesome. I have some questions on the chat. One sec.
So the first one is from Suganya Suresh Kumar. She says, how hard do you work to achieve your aim?
So I work very hard, Suganya. I'm not going to deny that. I have been working hard from school. I'm extremely hardworking. And one should work hard. As I said, there is no elevator to success. There's only one step at a time. And you should always work very hard. In my current role, I work long hours and I like it, because I'm doing what I enjoy doing. So if you enjoy what you do, and if you're in the space that you are, what you'd like to do, then you will really work hard. And sometimes it happens that you may get into a profession you may not completely like, but are there other things in your life you can do? Is there an extracurricular activity that you can like and you can and that can give you enjoyment, right? So it depends where you are. But if you're in a space that you like being, then you're going to work very hard. And that happens with me. I love HR and I love... And I work very hard in my space. And there's no shortcut to that. Yeah.
There are a couple of more questions.
Yeah. Rakshita, which is the best book you read that motivates me a lot? Okay, so there's one book which is I will get you the name of the book. It talks about how if you do something for 100 hours, it becomes your strength, right? I'm forgetting the name of the book, Aditya. I will send you the name of that book, right? And please do read that. It's one of the best.
Malcolm Gladwell book.
Sorry?
Is the Malcolm Gladwell book or is it?
Malcolm Gladwell. I'm forgetting the name. I'm forgetting the name. Sorry.
The Tipping Point.
Not the Tipping Point. I forget it. I will send it to you, Rakshita. Maybe I'll pass on the name to ma'am and she can share with you. Yeah. It just very simply tells you what you can do to achieve something, right? And I find that book really useful for that. Yeah. Taniska says, thank you for the wonderful session. Really informative. Thank you so much, Taniska. That's very kind of you. My ambition is to become a doctor, but at times I feel a little doubtful about my capability. What am I to do? When you chose history, were you confident? If suppose you had the doubtful, how did you overcome? So whenever I have doubt, Taniska, as I said, I always feel that if I was to achieve that success, how will I feel? And you all feel very nice. So that really motivates you and say, whatever may happen, I will work hard and I will achieve it, right? When you are doubtful, always think, why are you doubtful? Are you feeling scared that you can't achieve it? Do you think you need to learn something more to achieve it? And if you have figured out what all things you have to do to achieve something, just go ahead on that, right? You're very young, but I will still recommend all of you that if you can learn of some techniques which can help you manage your stress or your doubt, it can be simple yoga, simple breathing techniques. It's going to really help you. So two things I'm saying. One, be very clear about what you need to do to achieve. And if you're on that journey, just have confidence. Say, I'm doing everything to go there. So I should not have a doubt on myself. The second thing is, as you are learning and as you're growing, and now itself, if you can put some habits of either doing a little yoga or doing any activity which calms your mind, right? It can even be listening to music, right? Just do that to overcome that and tell yourself, this will go away, right? I will reach there. I will be capable. I'm doing everything to go there, right? That would be my reaction to that, right? Suganya, I think we've answered your question, hopefully. How can you improve your knowledge, Mahati? As I said, learn from everything. Read a newspaper. Read a book, right? Listen to people who are in a career you'd like to be in, right? Anywhere that you can pick up knowledge, you should do. And these small, small things really help you get to a lot of knowledge, right? That is what I would say. Balashri, you want to fulfill your dreams and you want to also help your friends achieve your dreams. For dreams, one, have the ambition to say, I will do everything and I will work hard. Okay. Second thing is, find out what is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 you need to do step by step to achieve that goal. Right. And the third thing is, as I was saying, find out techniques to manage your stress. If you want to do your friends help achieve your dream, do the three same things for them. Ask the three same questions to them and help them find answers to that. Make sense, Balashri? Who's your role model? My role model is one of my bosses I have worked earlier. She's a fantastic human being. Apart from being a fantastic HR person, she's also a very, very kind, nice, analytical, and empathetic human being and great at communication. She's my role model, right? Why did I select my MBA as my career, Shriniti? Because I thought, as I was saying, that science plus history, analytical mind plus people mind made me feel that the best profession I can put both use to will be human resources. That's why I selected an MBA and that too in HR. MBA because it gives me a professional journey and I can make my career in it, right? Okay, Janani is asking me, have you ever been in depression in this pandemic time? While you were depressed, how did you overcome your state of mind? I've been anxious. I've had a little bit of anxiety, right? Because we've been working from home for like more than a year.
I have been at a certain place with my kids, but my husband is in another place, so my kids are not getting time to spend with my husband. Life is not, as we call, normal, right? But the way I've overcome is to say this, that this too shall pass. All of this will pass, and there will we will get back to whatever best is normal, wearing our mask, taking care of things, we will get back to normal, right? I believe, Janani, the only reality in life is that everything passes, right? So that's one thing I've told my mind. The other thing is I do small things which keep me happy, right? So I do a little bit of exercise to keep me happy. As I said, for me, time management is to find time in a day to spend with my kids, right? So I do that so that I feel happy with them, right? And they get my time, right? I do small things to also distract my mind from being stressful, because what is there, right? We have to get through it, and we have to get to a space where everything is going to be okay. So this is how I have managed it. This too shall pass is my philosophy. Two, I've done small things whenever I felt stressed or depressed as to how I can manage this stress or depression, right? Again, Shivani, thank you so much for your kind words. I'm very happy that you found it useful. Right, Aditya, I think we are done with the questions. Yeah, and we are on dot 2 o'clock.
I think the book is Outliers. I was just lost in my mind. Yeah.
Yes. Can you type it on chat for the kids?
Yes.
Yeah.
So I think it's Outliers by Malcolm Gladwell. I was thinking, where was this? I read it.
Yes. This is my favorite book, and I feel it really very simply tells you how you can do something to develop something in yourself, how you should work hard. That's the book. Thank you so much.
Okay, so thank you so much, Harshita, for that wonderful session. So I think one of the quotes that we can remember here is, if winter comes, can spring be far behind? So anyone remembers the poet who wrote that line, those immortal lines? If winter comes, can spring be far behind? Anyone knows who wrote that? Look, if you don't, then maybe Google that before the next time. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, yeah.
Thank you so much, Harshita. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Anyone who knows, tell me in the next session. Okay. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Abhita, ma'am, if you could just give a few closing remarks.
So, is it D.T. Shelley?
Sure, Aditya.
Yeah, that's right, ma'am. That's right.
Yeah, thank you so much, Harshita, for sharing your experiences and valuable discussion about how important communication is in one's life. I'm sure students would have enjoyed your motivational speech. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Aditya, for introducing Harshita to us. I also thank everyone in the session for their cooperation, support, and active participation. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.